Okay, that makes me super psyched to be practicing again. This vlog could be like 8 hours long if I left the camera running the whole time. Because now I've got like, I found a mood. Like there's something happening here. And this is the most fun part for me. This is like the really like the nexus of the universe of like creativity, I think, when I get in this mood and this mode. I haven't touched my instrument since I did that thing with Adrian Portier the other day, the handpan player. I'm glad I'd been practicing before that. I felt pretty loose. You know, having that little jam session with him here at the apartment. But I haven't played since. That was a couple of days ago. It's amazing how fast it gets kind of just a little bit off. The accuracy, kind of the timing, the touch. Just, I feel the level dip just slightly. Which is not good because I have a solo show here in LA on in a couple of days' time. It's not a public thing, unfortunately, otherwise I would tell you guys about it. It's a charity event that I'm playing at. And it's a kind of a weird one for me because there are gonna be a lot of people there that I know, but they really don't know me as a musician. They know me as more from like the tennis world. So that's gonna be a little strange for me. I'm normally kind of equipped going into a situation, going into a concert with the fact that people are generally there because they bought a ticket because they know me and they came to listen to like a certain kind of music. This is me doing my thing, but for a bunch of people who have never heard it before and have never even heard me play before, and some of them didn't even know I was a musician. So kind of a strange situation to be walking into, but great challenge. I just want to be ready for it. And it's those things like, how do you get ready for a show? Or how do you get ready to perform at your best? How can you possibly do everything you can to give yourself the best chance of success? And we're only talking about like a 30-minute set here, tops. It's just a little thing at a charity event. People are going to speak. There's going to be all kinds of other stuff going on. I am the least important element of this night. But I take it very seriously, you know, and I take every performance very seriously. And I don't want to let myself down, and I want to make sure I put on a good show. It's like that whole thing of you're kind of only as good as your last show. And I go in there with the attitude of, and this time it should be pretty true, I normally go in there with the attitude that there's at least one person in the audience who's never seen you play before, and you know, you want to make it as special for the person hearing you play for the first time as it is for those people who perhaps follow your career and follow your concerts and come and see you on a regular basis. You want to be really, really consistent across the board. And I think that is what... That's what's on my mind, that's the focus, that's the concept. And now I have to try and pull together my technique and my kind of like last minute world tour solo show setup thing and try and remember some of the songs I'm playing and put a little 30-minute set list together. Normally I kind of just go until I can't go anymore and the concert could be an hour and a half, but this time there's like a time limit on it, so. Number one, it's just nice to have something to work towards. Like, I know that I have this gig and know that I have to practice and I have to prepare for it. And so much of my set can be improvised. I really enjoy that. So that's kind of, I'm kind of testing the waters now, like feeling it out, like what do I feel like playing. I have this thing in the looper from the jam with Adrian the other day. I'm going to get rid of that. And I want to get back to some soundscapey kind of things. I'm going to bust out a bunch of pedals. I'll probably do a longer session tomorrow working on the pedal setup. But I definitely want to get into some atmospheric stuff, and you know, there's that whole thing. Like, it's tough to sell a jazz gig sometimes. It's definitely, I think, tough to sell the concept on paper, at least, of one bass player performing, and that's it. Okay, it's going to be jazz. It's going to be improvised. There's no singer. There are no words, and it's a bass player. Like, that might be the toughest sell out there. Or one of them, anyway. I don't know. There are probably more bizarre instruments playing on their own that would be a tougher sell. But anyway, it's a kind of a tough sell to start with. So I'm always conscious of like the range and kind of including everyone. I don't want to exclude or alienate anyone in the audience. And I'm sure there are going to be so many different tastes and people who are into so many different things. And it's not like, okay, I want to play one like rockabilly thing, and then I want to play a rock and roll tune, and then I want to play a pop song. It's not like that. I'm not trying to satisfy everyone's like genre specific needs. But in terms of the palette and the soundscape and the emotion I'm able to kind of, you know, express and draw out of people, that's the key, and that's a huge challenge. That's something I really relish. And it can be something so simple as well. Like I just have I have my Miura compressor, I have my PS5, my Boss Super Shifter, and I have the delay pedal, the Nova repeater in the chain. I do have the volume pedal, so I can kind of swell things in, and of course I have the looper at the end of the situation. So I can create kind of a pad and a rhythmic thing as well, like a percussive thing. Now I can dial the delay back a little bit. I'll more than likely play American Elm. That's always a great one to get loose because it's just over like a C pedal like this. But there are just so many options now. Be super psyched to be practicing again. This vlog could be like 8 hours long if I left the camera running the whole time, because now I've got like, I found a mood, like there's something happening here, and this is the most fun part for me. This is like the really like the nexus of the universe of like creativity, I think, when I get in this mood and this mode. There are a couple of accuracy things that you just heard there that were kind of mistakes, but great that I'm doing that now and I'm getting that feedback, so I know exactly what I need to work on. Probably need to dial back the density of it a little bit, play a little bit more open, get my fingers more warmed up. The whole melody, that's a good sign. so already I'm kind of feeling a few things that I need to work on, some diatonic stuff. So that was kind of great just to remember, okay, I can do it. I was freaking out just a little bit, like, whoa, it's been a while. Haven't played solo shows in a really long time, and this thing is coming up in 2 days. I've been working like nonstop. I'm gonna give you guys a little sneak look at this. I've been kind of working nonstop on getting the websites working and like really just redesigned, and VBO is getting a huge face. I can't, I mean, it's gonna be kind of an epic relaunch of VBO. New name, a bunch of new content, moving all my original members, of course, to the new platform and kind of relaunching, but getting my artist website going. I'm really happy with this. You can go check it out, yanekgwizdala.com. It is linked below in the description of this video. And Chelsea has been helping out big time with design and fonts and logos. It's awesome. We are so close to getting the house together, and just really, really psyched all around. So I've been kind of neglecting the playing side of things as well. Chelsea has like a huge week of playing and learning music and gigs and all kinds of crazy stuff coming up. So we're both kind of crazed right now in different areas. And I kind of neglected the music a little bit for a couple of days, but it's slowly filtering back into my fingers now. And how long does that take you guys? Do you guys feel like there's like a certain amount of time, like if you take a day off, or is it 2 days, or can you go like 2 weeks without playing and then just jump straight back into it? How long is that for you? I really appreciate the questions from yesterday's Q&A, like the Chelsea and I picked out. Like we said, it's so awesome when you guys leave questions and comments, and obviously we can't get to them all. I apologize in advance for that profusely, but we get to as many as we can. And like we said, it's really fun when we get to kind of discuss the stuff ourselves and end up, you know, you guys inspire us to ask each other questions. But my question for you today, I guess, is how long does it take before you kind of feel the rust setting in on the fingers and on the brain? I don't know, for me, maybe it's like a couple of days. Maybe that's what I'm experiencing now. I think maybe it changes as well. I seem to remember going like a week before without playing and coming back and being super fresh. And it's not terrible right now, but it doesn't feel like as relaxed and as on demand perhaps as I would like. And I'm having like musical ideas that I'm not able to execute perhaps as smoothly or as eloquently as I could have done a few days ago. It felt really loose when I was playing with Adrian, because I just come off kind of an intense few days of practicing. So how long does it take you guys? Let me know. Do you have questions about that? For me, you've kind of seen my process of getting back into it is kind of simplifying things and playing diatonically, making sure I have the basics together, nothing too complicated. Of course, I have something specific that I'm practicing for Saturday night for this little solo show. But how long does it take you? You know, can you go a week? Can you take a 2 week vacation and come back and still be cool? Still be able to go out and play a gig like 2 or 3 days after you get back? Let me know. I'd be really interested to hear your feedback, hear your response to that. I'm gonna practice a little bit more because I really need to. That is today's vlog done. And as I update the websites and get things moving, I'll let you guys further in the door and show you what's going on. It's super exciting. And I'm kind of having fun like being back, you know, designing and coding and doing all kinds of things with my websites and like getting new content together. I'm working on this course for the lesson website. You're kind of breaking down Pino Palladino, and like I just was sitting there thinking, I love this guy's playing so much, and there are some really iconic performances that he's given on records. I was like, this is the stuff I should be talking about, and sitting here with the P-bass with the nylon tape wound strings on it and playing those lines and talking about why I love them and how I transcribe them and how I jam to records that he was playing on, him and many other people, of course, and then how I applied it to my own playing. So that's kind of where my brain's headed this week. Gonna be working on a new course, a new 12-part course for that, plus some other super cool ideas. Just kind of happy about life right now. And I'm glad I get to share that with you guys. So today's vlog is done. I'm gonna practice a little bit more, but I will see you guys tomorrow.